so much like symbolism within the archer.
Yeah.
Like even like the fire burning in the beginning, like I was there on purpose because it signifies like me burning like the old and
new
coming. And like I've stepped into a new version of myself because I've got like new knowledge and information on me.
Music.
Yeah, I just grew up in like a musical household. I'm sure everyone knows. When I figured out that I could do it myself, like finding treasure.
Yeah,
I've just never looked back since.
What seems like the best part of doing music?
Knowing that you guys kind of resonate with something that I write.
Yeah.
It's amazing to me. It's like when I met you guys in Manchester, I think I was more nervous.
I think we're listening to like music that's got like a real story behind it, like real music. Like I think like this era of music that's coming out now, I don't really like, resonate to it a lot.
What song would you say that you guys listen to with mine and kind of resonate with?
Especially the Big Dad at the end when he's saying that you're singing on the couch.
Brown Sugar.
He's just like, you think it in your head and he's just like nice to think about it.
Was he scared to let them hear it?
Yeah. My mom's still asking questions.
It's nice though, isn't it, to see how they take interest to see what your perspective on life is. Because theirs is completely different from yours.
Yeah. You know what's mad? Like, my dad, I remember the first time I played my dad music, essentially he was like, this is shit. But he didn't really say it was shit.
Yeah.
But I could tell that he didn't like it. Because he don't care if I'm his son. Like, he would just tell me, bro, it's not good.
Yeah.
Or he'll tell me it's really good. But when I played it to him, when I played him the EP through and through, by the time I got to the intro, he actually cried.
Oh.
I've never seen him cry before.
Yeah.
That was like a moment for me, because I was like,
it hit me.
And my mum, she came to see me perform in London, so obviously we did the tour and then I performed the outro whilst my mum was there.
Yeah.
Oh, that was awesome.
I did. Like, I get emotional when I perform it, but she didn't understand why I got so emotional until she actually started listening to the words.
Yeah.
And literally, even like last week, she was like, can I ask you a question? And I was like, what? And she was like, what did you, like, talk to me about the outro? And I was like, mom, man, not now. I kind of ready to go in depth with it.
Yeah.
But do you think listening to something like that makes you think about, like, your relationship with
your parents? Yeah.
Okay,
so it just takes you back to, like, your childhood as well, like, what you used to do with your parents.
And opposites attract to love, right?
Yeah.
I love that.
Like,
I don't know, I love it.
See, you know what's funny? I actually wrote Opposites Attract when I was 17.
What?
Yeah.
So,
that's
not. And like, so I'm 26 now.
Is that how long it took you to get off your chest?
Essentially.
Yeah. Not in a bad way,
yeah,
like,
yeah.
Like,
essentially,
you do it in your own time, don't you?
Yeah, so I'd literally just like repurposed the song. And I wrote it when I was like 17, but I felt the pain, but I couldn't
describe it.
Yeah, and it's like obviously, God knows how many years later, I've been able to like articulate it in a way that
you feel like you're matured more so you can word it better.
100%. So do you think you would want to hear like more like personal music from me?
Definitely.
So do you think I should do a part two to bring it to you? Or?
Yeah.
At London and Manchester, it was like, it's kind of inspired. So how do you guys kind of connect with like London and the impact of music and stuff?
There's a lot more younger artists in London, I think, that are obviously telling their stories of how they've struggled and everything.
Yeah.
I think if it is artists in Manchester, it's artists that are like under the radar, like they're not very known. Like H is probably like our biggest one at the minute.
If you found an artist and didn't have a story, do you think you would
listen to his music?
I think for the energy, I'd listen to it for. Even just like riding to work, just like that. Yeah.
I want to say thank you actually personally to you guys for like almost motivating me and inspiring me to want to keep like writing.
Yeah.
People sometimes
feel
like you just need that little bit of motivation just to keep yourself going.
Yeah.
My story can be that.
I think one of the rest of your music's gonna
be like that.